baby, this is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves. Hi everybody, how are you doing? Well, this is what you came for, isn't it? Little old me talking away over some of the megastars of pop. As always, I say if you want to hear these songs on their own, go out and buy the album which they came from. Either the artist album, or if you want to get the whole lot, go for the compilation. Now that's what I call music. 94. Originally released July 2016, under 4 years old now. We're going to be taking a quick look through the album, seeing what's what, asking ourselves which songs still sound good. Now, a few empires have risen and fallen since this album was released, so although it's less than 4 years old, in some ways it feels like eons ago. I make it that this album was the one that came out around the time of the Brexit referendum. Interesting to see if that affects the music. Certainly this first song is a UK-US collaboration. Calvin Harris and Rihanna once again. This is what you came for. Pretty good collab. Calvin's really coming good again. It's had over 2 billion views, this one. Rihanna's in good voice. So yeah, pretty strong opener. Both these guys have been around for a good decade now. We'll find this actually, a lot of the people on this now, they've been around since the mid-noughties. Some of them have been on almost every now, including Calvin and Rihanna. They must have racked up a good 20 songs each, I would have thought. Maybe even 50 between them. This is up at the upper echelons, I reckon. How are we going to follow this one then? Well, it's another veteran, Justin Timberlake. Maybe not quite as regular. He comes and he goes. But you can't stop the feeling. This is from Trolls. And it's one of those post-70s, 80s funk ones. There's been a fair few. In a way, he was one of the pioneers of that. He was doing that kind of live drum-based stuff way back with things like Rock Your Body. So it's kind of a return to that sound for him. Great groove. The song itself is a bit weak. It's not too bad. Now we've got a really good one next. Kungs, depending on accent, versus Cooking on Three Burners, firing on all cylinders, and that's This Girl. We'll stick that one on. There's Calvin and Rihanna. This is what you came for. Pretty strong opener. And we follow that one up. Kungs versus Cooking on Three Burners. This Girl. Interesting sound. Quite a kind of a Motown-y vocal. Sort of sloppy house groove. Yeah, I like it. Interesting. Very interesting song. Nice brass. We follow this one up with another couple of veterans. Sia and Sean Paul, not the most obvious match. It's Cheap Thrills. It's not too bad, actually. Not too great, not too bad. I do find with Sia that she kind of uses the same chord pattern in all her songs. This one's got a bit more of a dancehall feel, mainly due to Sean's influence. So it's okay. Now, a really poor song with a strangely current title, Work From Home. I don't think they meant sat there at your computer logging in via the VPN. More about working those bodies. It's Fifth Harmony featuring Ty Dolla Sign. I find it really dire, actually. The beat is piss poor. There's hardly anything to it. Such instruments there are kind of overproduced. The synth line's not too bad. It's a bit like a slowed down version of Gotta Get Through This. But it's a bit annoying all in all. Doesn't really endear itself to the listener. Neither really does, excuse pronunciation, DNCE, is it Dunce maybe? Or Dance? Cake by the Ocean. Now they're not talking about that famous made up drug, cake. I hope not, because the effects of that are horrible. Cake by the Ocean, I think it's a euphemism. Yeah, it's kind of boy band pop rock. It's kind of a bit crass, really. It's not too bad. We'll follow that one up with Clean Bandit and Louisa Johnson, and I'll get this one on. It's another really good dancey tune. That was Kungs, Cooking on Three Burners, and This Girl. Yeah, that's a right tune. So is this. Clean Bandit featuring Louisa Johnson. And it sounds a bit like this. Take it away, guys. Tears. Takes a bit of time to get going. Keep them in suspense. Tease them. Make them wait. Okay. Sean Paul. Back once again. Barely three songs later. This time with Little Mix. And Hair. Sean Paul does what Sean Paul always does. He'll never change. He would literally never change. There's lots and lots of drums on that one. All over the shop. It's not too bad. Little Mix always put a bit of quality in there. So yeah, fair play. Next up, Chainsmokers and Dire. That's spelled D-A-Y-A. God almighty. Die by Name. Is it Die by Nature? Don't Let Me Down. She sounds a bit like Sierra, actually. That's such silly pronunciation. It gets a bit annoying. It's okay. It's a bit weak. It's kind of pop trap. The Chainsmokers really seem to have gone downhill. When you consider their best song was a novelty song, what does that say? Okay, good old Justin Bieber's back with Company. Very middling, not too bad. Not too great, not really a lot to say about it. I like Callum Scott, Dancing on My Own. Acoustic ballad time, just a voice and a guitar. Quite overall, but it's nice, it's emotional, so yeah, gets a free pass. Next up, Pink, Just Like Fire, from Alice Through the Looking Glass. Well, it's hardly White Rabbit. It's quite dynamic though. For Pink, it's quite inoffensive. Fairly interesting beats to it. So yeah, it's okay. Okay, first of two Ariana Grande ones now. Dangerous Woman. It's got that kind of 6-8 timing. So it's quite an innovative production. She's certainly got great production values on her stuff. Yeah, not too bad at all, really. Okay, we follow that one up with Nick Jonas featuring Tove Lo and Close. It's another one that I guess you'd call it a kind of an electro ballad. Should we stick it on so you can make your own mind up? Yeah, Nick Jonas and Tove Lo. Very big production values on it. That was Clean Bandit featuring Louisa Johnson and Tears. And here's Nick Jonas and Tove Lo. Close. So yeah, it doesn't really get very up tempo. It kind of builds. Some interesting productions on this album, definitely. Meghan Trainor, no, in capital letters, N-O. Well, against my better judgment, she's another one who seems like an easy target, kind of low-hanging fruit, but I don't actually mind it. There's quite a lot going on, and it's, again, it's quite a dynamic song. It moves around, does this, it does that. She's got different facets to her voice. So yeah, it's alright. It's kind of a yes, really, or a grudging yes. I wouldn't maybe put it in capital letters. Treat You Better, Shawn Mendes. Incredibly bog standard, kind of boy bandy stuff, even though there's one of him, he sounds like a boy band. A one man boy, or a one boy boy band. Years and Years featuring Tove Lo, back again. It's okay, it's not as good as this one. A little bit irritating. Yeah, nothing special really. You've got to stand out in these times. Okay, here's a very, very unlikely collab now. Incredibly strange. Sigma, who essentially a kind of D&B, albeit the pop side of it, featuring Take That, wow, and Cry. So it's Sigma moving away from kind of underground D&B one step further. Take That, basically just provide vocals on it. It's essentially pop D&B. Yeah, it's an interesting collab. Not quite sure what to make of it, but both parties got talent, so give it a free pass. Bastille. Now, I really didn't like their Off The Note. I found this stuff a bit bland so far. This is their best yet. Good grief. Yeah, the vocals are a bit irritating, but the music's really good. Another one that's pretty dynamic, and I like the fact there's lots of dynamic songs on this now. Stuff that builds, it ebbs, it flows, has quiet bits, has loud bits. Especially when you think back in the noughties, a lot of stuff was very kind of one-dimensional. It would just be one beat. Over and over again. That doesn't happen anymore. People switch things up a lot more now. Okay, some guitar pop now. First time we've had any for ages, really. No, we've had elements of it. Viola Beach and Boys That Sing. Almost kind of post-Britpop, really. I'll stick it on. It seems kind of a bit of a throwback in some ways. But this stuff never really dates. There we go, Nick Jonas and Tove Lo, and the fairly epic Close. And here's Viola Beach, Boys That Sing. So yeah, a lot more kind of retro sounding. Still got a groove there. One of the more obscure songs on this now, I think. Quite an interesting one. They're from Warrington. Okay. Next up, it's our old friends Coldplay, Up and Up. They're really back again. Now, this is another one that's dynamic. It really is. I didn't really like it for the first kind of minute or two. And then when it really gets... about the second chorus and the real live drums come in after a rather clinky clunky drum machine and you get a really good drum guitar solo, it really kind of locks into place. So it really does build up and up, that one. You've got to bear with it, and once you know what's coming up, it makes you a lot more interested in how it gets there. So fairly brave, and proof that, you know, you don't have to kind of blast people with what's going to happen in the first 30 seconds. I think that's the overriding theme of this album, is actually a very dynamic, teasy album. Now, this one does the same in reverse, in fact. It starts off nicely, and you think, oh, this is good, and then suddenly it goes downhill. It's a real curate's egg. It's a duet between Nash, I just think of Nasher, Dennis the Menace's dog, Nash with a G, silent G, as in gnashing of teeth, featuring Olivia O'Brien. I hate you, I love you. Well, Olivia, I love your bits, but Nash, I wouldn't say I hate you. That's a bit strong, but I think you really, you spoil the song. And I know you're the main artist on it. You might have played piano and done all the production and stuff, but your voice is awful, and all the effing and blinding. And I'm sure it's not on the now version, but totally crass. It shows a lack of vocabulary, really. Olivia's bits are really nice, but Nash's bits, not so good. Sorry. Okay, Drake, Hotline Bling. His voice is kind of an acquired taste, albeit a lot of people have acquired it. It's got some nice music to it. I do like the chords, and I like the kind of string organy sound in the background. The beat is okay, a bit plastic, but it's not bad. This is Hotline Bling. The word bling loses it a couple of points. Right, Galantis, they're really cheesy. They really are cheesy. It could have been good. There's some good elements, some good little bits of breakbeat. But all in all, it's just a bit wrong. That's no money, no points over really. Next up, we've got Snake and Bipolar Sunshine. I'll get this one on. I tell you what, there's some mental band names, aren't there, or artist names. Bipolar Sunshine. But yeah, this is Middle. Is it in the middle, or is it really good, or is it really bad? Actually, it's pretty good. Very well produced. Okay, now, I wish I'd just held fire actually and played this next song. I'll play a little bit of this one, and I'll get lined up the next one, and I'll tell you the story while we're waiting. Okay, the song is called Panda, and it's by Desiigner, with two eyes. And I don't just mean he's got two eyes in his head. I mean, you spell Desiigner with two eyes. Now, a few minutes ago, we were in Warrington with Viola Beach. Let's head east a bit along the M62. Around that awful bit, around the edge of Manchester. It joins up with the M60. And then go past Bolton and Bury, and you end up at Rochdale, a place I know well. Somewhere in Rochdale, you'll find a guy who works, well, he did work in a phone shop a few years ago. He might have moved on to greater things. But back in 2016, in Rochdale, there was a bit of a bedroom producer with a guy by the name of Menace. Maybe Dennis the Menace. Maybe Nash was his dog. Anyway, said producer came up with a beat which he put on YouTube. And it was picked up by Kanye West's label. Who said, oh, this is a bit good, this. Can we use this? And they bought the beat. And they transplanted it over to America. And the result is Panda. And this song, I really like. This is a contender for the best of the album. I like the concept of it. I like the link with Rochdale in America, which is a kind of reverse of history when cotton came over from America and it was milled in Rochdale. Now Rochdale's making beats and they're going back to America. So here we go, Panda. And it's a very dark song. It's got a very kind of spooky feel to it. Lots of kind of yeah, interesting, really interesting. Definitely my possibly best song on the album, certainly one of the most interesting. Okay, Kent Jones isn't from Kent, I don't think. He's not from Royal Tunbridge Wells. Don't mind. I don't mind it. See what I did there. I do like the bass. And I guess it's kind of moving over a bit into this new paradigm now. So yeah, it's alright. Sex. Let's talk about sex, baby. Sex has been coming up quite a bit in these last few nails, hasn't it? I talk about what's on the nails. If the nails present me sex, I'll talk about sex, baby. It doesn't sample, it reinterpolates the old Salt and Pepper song. Was it on a nail? I think it was. Nail 20, maybe. Way, way back. Salt and Pepper, we're no strangers to these. Cheat Codes, another great artist name. Featuring, or times, Chris Cross Amsterdam. Not Chris Cross, who did the jump. Way back. God, here's the scary thought. Chris Cross, they would have been middle-aged men by the time this now came up. Wow. So yes, let's talk about sex. Is it any good? It's okay. It's not that bad. You know, you could talk about sex in a sort of cool way. You could talk about it in a crass way. This one's fairly cool. It's quite Caribbean, as indeed are lots of the tracks on here. It's definitely the sound of 2016. Lots of steel drums and stuff coming in. Talking of which, Sigala and DJ Fresh and Imani Williams. Now, I really don't like the voice on that at all. It's really irritating. It eventually gets to kind of pop D&B, as you'd expect from Fresh. Well, not always. But yeah, it's nice production on it, and I do like the steel drums that give it that real summery 16 vibe. So it's just shame about the vocals, really. Now, good vocals from Craig David. What else? This time he's with Blonde. I'll get this one lined up. Nothing Like This. Now it's almost two songs in one. It's kind of 50% kind of garage, and then it's got a really kind of banging chorus, which is more kind of banging future house. So there we go, that's Desiigner with music by Menace, and that's Panda, and I really like that, that's really cool. And yeah, Blondie, was it? No, not Blondie, Blonde, imagine Blondie and Craig David. Wow, Nothing Like This. So yeah, you think it's all going to be nice and garagey and smooth, then halfway through it switches. We Don't Talk Anymore, not the old Cliff song. I was kind of hoping it would be. I was wondering how that would sound, and it wouldn't have put me past it, past Charlie Puth to do an old Cliff song. He's a fairly, let's say, white bread. Selena Gomez, yeah, it's quite a good duet actually. Their voices would go together quite well. Bit of chemistry there, not bad. Okay, we hit Ariana Grande's second song now, Into You. And I'd say this is probably the best Ariana Grande song so far. It's certainly one that builds up. It's got a really big chorus. I'll get it lined up actually. Yeah. So there we go, bit of Blonde and Craig David. Nice classy tune. Nothing Like This. And here's Ariana Grande. I really have problems with her name, don't I? Because I used to know someone called Ariane, wasn't it like a missile or something? Or a rocket? Into You, anyway. Right, okay, David Guetta, he's another old mainstay, been around a good decade now. Sometimes really good, sometimes not all that. I didn't really like Zara Larsson's last couple. She's alright on this one, actually. This one's for you. This is the Euro 2016 anthem from that tournament, if you remember that. France. And as such, it ends up with big football crowd vocals at the end. Takes a while to build to that point. And it does all sorts of kind of jiggery-pokery to her voice. In a way, I quite like the kind of chipmunk effects better than just her normal singing. So yeah, a good sporting anthem. Right. Jonas Blue's back with JP Cooper. Super Cooper or Pooper Cooper? That's the question. Perfect Strangers. I'd say Super Cooper. I mean, it's got a good voice. Jonas Blue's okay. He's a bit middling as a producer. The voice is what makes this one work. So yeah, good stuff. Hotter Than Hell. Dua Lipa. Not really. Bit middling. Quite hype. But really, kind of, it's about as hot as, I don't know, Blackpool in February, really. Nah, it's better than that. Let's say Filey on an April afternoon. Hotter than that. Right, Raging. Now, that one is really good. Kygo featuring Codaline. And yeah, that's really nice. Kygo stuff's pretty good, actually, all in all. I've liked it. It's awesome. Really kind of dreamy. Laid back, post house. Let's stick it up. Big chorus on this Ariana one. Actually giving her a good song for once. Good voice, but sometimes the songs have been a bit wet. So it's nice that they've given her a good melody to get her teeth into. Okay, there's Ariana, and I said it right. Here's Kygo featuring Codaline. Okay. This is followed. Now, here's a weird title. This song title's been ruined by Kevin Spacey. Selena Gomez, Kill 'Em With Kindness. If someone does something that you don't like, oh, you can get mad. Or you can take them by surprise. You can kill them with kindness. Yes, indeed. Very freaky. So that's kind of killed the song, really. As a song, it's alright. It's actually quite housey for Selena. So yeah, not too bad. Boys and girls, will.i.am's back with Pia Mia. Will.i.am almost seems like a guest on his own song here, but he often does. Puts so many kind of gadgets and machines and stuff in it. Some nice arpeggios on it. The lyrics take me back to Blur, Girls and Boys. And it's all stuff about girls liking boys and boys liking girls. Some boys liking some boys and some girls liking some girls. Etc, etc. People have rumoured about will.i.am. I don't talk about stuff like that. I talk about the music. But if you want to talk about that in the comments, feel free. Right, new girl, Reggie and Bully. Bully, darling, Bully. Wasn't that absolutely fabulous and stuff? This one's another Caribbean one. It's very calypso. It maybe doesn't really work sitting at home, but I'm sure in a street party it would be all the rage. So yeah, New Girl. And that was a TV show, wasn't it? Zoe Deschanel, do you remember her? Do you remember that? New Girl. Okay, Mamacita. We're going all around the world with this album. This is actually probably one of Tiny Temper's best for ages. In fact, I'll stick it on. And it's really interesting, actually, if you follow Tiny Temper's career, because he's been on these for a while now, he really goes with all the different trends that have been going. Because he started off way back with that real trancey synth stuff that started to get really annoying. Then he kind of went to more kind of grimy stuff. And now he's kind of going with the more carnival stuff. And yeah, this one, Mamacita, this features Wizkid. There we go, that's a great song from Kygo featuring Codaline and Raging. And now we're going another one that's sort of Hispanic. Let me get some details. Not my Macarena, Margarita. So yeah, it's quite a carnival-y sort of song. It's like that music in Scarface, you know the stuff I mean. Peruvian cocaine, Immortal Technique, check that. You might find that on the now. Okay, one more time, Craig David again, one more time. And it's more just straight garage, but it's very good, very quality stuff. I like it. And Cigala's back again with John Newman and Nile Rodgers. Now, I never knew that John Newman was born in Settle, a lovely little place up in the Yorkshire Dales. And he moved to Leeds, so fair play. He's another Leodian, another loiner. I'm an honorary loiner, if they'll have me. I've been here since 2012. Originally from Sussex, but yeah, I moved up north and I love it. Anyway, enough about me. John Newman, who might well be just standing over me as we speak, you never know. Noah Rogers, who's most definitely not from Leeds, and Cigala. So there's a really good combination and a half. Give me your love, and it's a really good. I mean, it couldn't really go wrong with those three elements, could it? Cigala, John Newman and Noel Rogers. I'll get it on to clear us out and we'll do the roundup. Yep, Noel Rogers provides some funky guitar stuff on it. John Newman does his brilliant vocals as always. If you're watching, John, pop in, have a cup of tea. And Cigala, ditto actually. Give me some tips on production. Could do some. I've got the new setup, and I'm taking on board all sorts of tips from these nows, I tell you. I'm actually going to start adapting some of the ideas from some of the very best of these songs, hopefully. This is all my homework. I've been wondering, a bit of soul searching about putting this whole series on YouTube, taking on board people's feedback. I accept some people might not like these videos. I accept that there's no production values or anything on them. It's literally a picture and me talking. I figure I just want to get through the whole series in this paradigm, and then any future videos can look at developing the style of them a bit. We're so near the end now. I'm just about hell for leather getting through the Now series. Looking back at this particular volume, I've really enjoyed it, actually. 94. It's funny, I'm as enthusiastic as the music makes me. Bad music and it's a real troll. Good music and it's a real pleasure. I found this one's had a lot to enjoy, actually. Right from the off, with Calvin and Rihanna. Good, strong opener. Justin Timberlake can be meh, he can be good. Can't Stop the Feeling's good. This Girl by Kungs and Cooking on Free Burners is really good. Cheap Thrills was adequate. First stinker of the album, Work From Home, Fifth Harmony. Cake by the Ocean's not all that either. Tears was good, Clean Bandit. Hair, meh, meh hair. Don't Let Me Down was a bit of a letdown. Company, adequate. Dancing on My Own, better than being in company. There we go, being on your own. Company's overrated. Kiss Like Fire, well, maybe it's like a sparkler, not an inferno. Dangerous Woman, first of two good Ariana Grande songs. Close, very good, Nick Jonas and Tove Lo. No by Megan's actually a yes for me. Treat You Better is okay. Desire wasn't as good as the other Tove Lo one, years and years. Sigma and Take That's an interesting collab. Good Grief, it's a good song by Bastille. Let down a bit by the vocals, but okay. Viola Beach, good song from Warrington. Up and Up, gets better as it goes along from Coldplay. I Hate You, I Love You. I hated the Nash bits, I love the Olivia bits. Hotline Bling's okay, but it loses points of the word bling. No Money, Galantis, no music either, shit. Middle by Bipolar, it's actually okay. And Snake, mustn't forget him. Possibly best song on the album, Panda, Desiigner. I Didn't Mind, Ken Jones, Don't Mind. Sex by Cheat Codes and Crisscross Amsterdam's okay. Maybe Foreplay than Sex, but Say You Do, Sigala and Marnie Williams, Let Down by Her Voice. Nothing Like This, Blonde and Craig David, very good collab. We Don't Talk Anymore's okay. Into You, very good, Ariana Grande. This one's for you, it's a good sporting song, David Guetta, Zara Larsson. Perfect Strangers, okay, good vocals by JP Cooper, good old Coops. Hotter Than Hell was adequate, a bit overrated. Raging's very good, Kygo. Killing With Kindness makes me laugh, the song name. Boys and Girls is okay, New Girls, meh. Mama Keita's pretty good. One More Time's very good, and Gimme Your Love's very good. So a good, strong album. Nice one. See you later, everybody. Take it easy. I'll be back next time. Last one from 2016. And now that's on Rock and Music 95. See you later.